In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a template for custom callouts. So the first thing we want to do is let's create some sections. Now, generally when I work with callouts, I have a four idea. So rectangles or straight lines, rounded corners, the ovals, and clouds. Now you can have different shapes within that. You can have squares, rectangles, short rectangles, tall rectangles. So you can come up with as many variations of these as you want. So the first thing we'll do is we'll create a section. So on my first slide, I'm going to add a section, and we'd call this rectangle section. And so I've got my rectangle section. I need to duplicate the slide. So now in between these, I'm going to add another section, and we'll call this one, we can call this the rounded section for rounded corners. Let me duplicate this slide a few times. And then on this section here, we might have the oval, right? So rename the section, we'll call it oval. And then the last section I might have is cloud. So add a section and we'll call this cloud. And then we've got our four main sections. So once I've got my sections, and it looks really nice in the slide sorter view, you can see I've got very clear distinct sections. So once I've got a section, what I'll want to do is build out a few cloud or a few templates for my callouts. So I might start with the rectangle. Now I can have all sorts of rectangular shapes with callouts. So I want to build those out. Generally, what I do is I'll take my body shape, and then we'll just use a triangle. And I take my triangle shape, and we'll just use this. And you're going to have typically like three positions. You'll have, you know, like an upper third, a middle position, and then maybe a lower third. And then you have the same thing on the bottom. You'll have a third, middle, third. So a lot of ways that you can do that. Now, once you build these out and save them, then you can flip them. So you don't need to do it for all the sides. So you do it for one side and then for the bottom, and then you save them out and flip them. So once you've built those, then what you would do is build out a lot of variations. So let's say I'm going to duplicate this just to show you how we would do that. So I'd go through this and build them out on the sides. Then I might do something like this where I have a call out that looks more like this. So then I've got more control over the shape. So I can have all sorts of rectangles. So I build those out, and then I want to save the file as my call out template, because if I want to change it, you know, I'm going to open that file, rename it, then I'll make my changes. This way I always have that master call out template. And then I build out my rectangles, and I would go ahead and however many rectangles I build out, I go ahead and duplicate all of those, and then I want to put those in the rounded, the oval, and the other sections as well. And so we'll just duplicate one of these slides to kind of show you how that would work. So then I'd take, let's say in the rectangle section I have 20 slides, I would duplicate those 20 and then put them in each section. So I would fill all these sections up with the exact same duplicates. Once I go to the rounded section, though, I'm going to select the shape, and then I'm going to go to Format, and I will change the shape, and I could do rounded. So, and then at that point, I've got the same thing, right? I can do a rounded shape that looks like this. So again, if I combine those, I've got my call out. I could copy those, and then I could have different levels of rounding. So I could have a more pill-like rounding. I could have real tight rounded corners like this, all sorts of things you can do. You can right click on the shapes here, edit the points, use the Bezier tool to create curves, you know, whatever you want to do. And then you create all sorts of options with the callouts. And then you would do the same thing. You'd save those as, you know, group them, save them as images, and you have custom callouts. Go over here, right? Oops. You select the shape, go to Format, I'd go through the ovals, assign the oval shape, and again, I might have to play around with the callouts and all that, but I've got the oval shape. I can create circles, fat ovals, thin ovals, all sorts of ovals, And the same thing with the thought clouds, change the shape. I've got the clouds here, and then I can play around with the shape that I get here. One of the things I like about the clouds, let's assume this is what I want, and I combine those shapes here, and you'll see it gets rid of all those little lines, right? So you got all these little lines. I think they kind of make it look dated, but when you bring them together, you get rid of the lines. It actually works well. So once you build out those initial shapes, save them as a template, and then open them up, save it again as a file name, and then you can customize the shapes and do whatever you want to with the callouts. You always have a callout ready to go.